Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today answering the question, do air intakes actually increase horsepower? So to answer this simply, but not necessarily directly up front, yes, air intakes can increase horsepower, but there are a lot of factors that come into play, so it's hard to just say indefinitely for every engine out there. Jumping into that, what are some of the ways in which an aftermarket intake can actually increase horsepower? There are really three primary ways, and that's going to be volume, efficiency, or colder air. So increasing air volume and flowing more air into the engine can increase power. Increasing efficiency and ultimately making it easier for the engine to actually pull in that air can also increase power. And then lastly, pulling colder air into the engine. Colder air is denser, and so that's going to be another way to potentially increase power with an intake. Now, the problem with all of that is most modern cars, anything from the 2000s and up, and even some older vehicles, just about every engine and vehicle out there has a very efficient and often cold air intake design directly from the factory. If you think about most intake systems, they are going to use a closed air box. They're often located in a cooler part of the engine bay, and a lot of the times most vehicles will have some sort of an inlet or some sort of a snorkel that's running behind the front grill or somewhere where it can pull in the coolest air possible. So when it comes to aftermarket intakes, it's really hard to find anything that's a true cold air intake and is actually going to pull in colder air than what the stock intake is able to do. And same thing goes for volume and efficiency. If you're making stock power, the stock airbox is going to be very efficient and effective. There are a lot of engineers designing these vehicles, and if it were really that easy to pick up more horsepower, they would likely do that with the factory intake design. Now, that said, on a stock engine, it's very unlikely to pick up any significant or meaningful power gains with an aftermarket intake system. There are some vehicles and engines out there that do have a slightly more restrictive intake directly from the factory, and in those cases, you might be able to pick up a few horsepower from an intake upgrade. However, with tuning and modifications, this is where you can really start to see the benefits of an aftermarket intake system. And the reason for that is when you start increasing power and really requiring more air being brought into the engine, a lot of the times these stock intakes are not necessarily designed for that. They're designed to be efficient for the stock power output. Now, suddenly when you start tuning the engine and doing additional modifications, and now you're making 20, 30, potentially 50 plus horsepower more than the stock engine would, then that's where you start getting into that situation where that stock intake system can start becoming more inefficient and a little bit more of a restriction. So if you are tuning and modifying the vehicle, again, exact power gains will really depend on your specific engine and what modifications you have. But a lot of the times you can expect to see power gains there of roughly 3 to 7 horsepower. Some cars may even see more considerable gains of 10 to 15 plus horsepower. And that's going to be more common on forced induction engines. Any supercharged, turbocharged, procharged engine is generally going to see bigger power gains because when you start tuning these engines, you're running a lot more boost. You can see gains of 50, 100 horsepower with just a tune, and that's going to be a lot more demanding than the stock airbox of most engines can keep up with and manage. In summary of all of this, as I mentioned with intakes, there's just so many nuances. It really comes down to a car by car and engine by engine basis. But most of the time, stock vehicles, if you just do an air intake, you're often not going to see any notable power or performance gains. However, once you start modifying the vehicle with things like tuning, maybe headers, exhaust systems, or especially forced induction, that's where aftermarket intakes can start to see much more considerable and impressive power gains of 3 to 7 horsepower on a lot of cars, and potentially even 10 to 15 plus wheel horsepower on some forced induction engines. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.